Hi everybody, I'm Kirsten Meekin from Naio Nails. Today we are going to do jelly slash glass nails. Some people call them jelly, some people call... Other people call them glass. I think they should be called glass because they're not jelly.
But I think they look like jelly.
They look like jelly, but they feel like glass.
Okay.
I like that. We are joined today by... I mean, this woman is just amazing. I've loved her for a very long time. And I've been honoured to do her nails before. Building you up, don't worry. The pedestal as well, Julie High. Am I calling you Vicky Lavender, though?
Burn.
Vicky Burn. Vicky, you were Burn. Lavender, weren't you?
I'm Lavender Burn.
Lavender Burn. Vicky Lavender Burn. But you might recognise her voice. Those of you that watch Pretty Little Claws, which is our second channel, this is Vicky from the channel. Pretty Little Claws, and we're going to make her have Pretty Little Claws today. So everybody can see what you look like now. Yeah!
Say hello.
Hi.
This is Vicky with the crazy hair.
That's not how she says hello. She goes,
hiya.
Hiya.
I'm Vicky.
There you are. Now you can see her face.
Oh, I can feel like I'm burning up. I've got bright red.
I've known Vicky. How long have I known you for?
About 7-8 years.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Vicky's had some training with me as well, haven't you?
I have.
Yeah. How many classes have you done?
A few.
Mm-hmm.
Quite a few.
Done boot camp with me and everything.
Yeah.
So yeah, she's very good.
She's got her wedding nails done.
Yeah.
And honeymoon nails.
I was honoured to do.
And honeymoon
and
nails.
And honeymoon nails.
Wedding you had two separate ones.
Honeymoon. Yeah. Oh, because I just have one.
Yeah.
Wow.
Nice and classy, and then bright.
Nice and trashy.
What?
She didn't have her hair this colour for a wedding?
No, it was brown, plain, boring.
Yeah. So we've already prepped Vicky's nails. Now Vicky's taking her nails off. Vicky does like a chew. So we've got a bit of chewage, you know, on the fingers. I'm just going to wipe over it with gel residue wipe-off solution because I have already prepped them, so I've removed surface shine and prepped the cuticles, removed all the nastiness from around. Non-living tissue. That's what we've removed.
Nastiness.
I've got lots of nastiness on mine, don't worry. I have far more than you had on yours because mine, I get so much cuticle, it's like it just wants to keep taking over my whole nail. So, I've been wanting to do these jelly slash glass nails for ages, and I think Vicky's the perfect person. She can carry that look off, because Adam can't carry that look off.
How do you know? I think I could. I'd like glow in the dark, me. Oh, sorry.
You've just ruined it now. He's ruined it. Let the cat out of the bag. So, the way we're going to do this is we're going to actually use some glow-in-the-dark products as well. So, not only are they going to be glass nails, I'm going to call them glass nails. I know people call them jelly as well, but I like to call them glass. Not only are they going to be like glass, stained glass, but they're going to actually glow in the dark. So, Vicky can sit there in bed and go, look at my nails. They're so pretty. Right, so I'm going to fit the sculpting forms first of all. We're going to do one hand at a time because I like to do one hand at a time because I want to give my client, Vicky, a free hand to scratch her bottom and pick her nose.
Always handy.
Always handy.
Mm-hmm.
So we're just going to do one hand at a time. I'm actually going to start here. So, we're going to do a stiletto, so we're going to come straight out this side wall. And I'm going to come along, and we're going to come to about... Ooh.
Long.
3.5?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Nice. Yes.
It's been a while since you've had long nails.
Yeah. No, I only took them off yesterday.
I mean, that long.
How long do you normally have them for when you're filming?
Probably a two.
Yeah, a two for filming.
Yeah.
Mine's probably slightly longer, but mine are long for me. to be honest. But I seem to be coping fine with them. I thought because I hadn't had long nails for such a long time that I would really struggle. But I've adapted quite well. So, what's your favourite thing about filming the Pretty Little Claws channel?
The hotel she stays in.
Stop it!
Is it not a very nice hotel?
I've tried every single hotel in Hartlepool.
Have you?
Yeah, genuinely.
Really?
Yeah.
She got one left.
Have you done loads of reviews? Are they all really bad reviews?
They're different. They're special.
Maybe whoever's watching this channel, if they can recommend a really good hotel for Vicky to stay in Hartlepool, just comment below, please. You'd think that Adam would know, but I suppose Adam doesn't really stay
in
his hometown.
Well, no, he put me in last time, and he stayed there 15 years ago.
Oh, and it was lovely then, was it? Is it still the same?
Still.
Same decor.
Yeah, it was. It was lovely and quiet, though, unlike some of the others.
Oh, what have the others been like?
That I got up at like 5:30 one morning and banged hell out of next door's door because they had the music blaring. But it was like full on boom, 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 boom music. It
wasn't even nice music.
It wasn't nice music, no.
And it was that was like on a Tuesday, wasn't it?
Are you kidding me?
No, Tuesday. And then I had to ring reception and I was like, they're having a party. I'm all right if my alarm goes off, but if I'm woken up earlier than my alarm, no.
Not good.
No.
No likely.
No.
So apart from the fabulous hotels that you stay in Hartlepool, what else do you enjoy?
The sandwich shop.
Why have we not got a good sandwich shop?
It's my friend's sandwich shop.
Oh my
What is
God.
It, a French one?
No, my friend's sandwich shop. It is good.
What's this sandwich shop called?
Bianco's.
Bianco's!
It's amazing. The best, like, cheese-topped fries and, oh.
So you like the food, you don't really like the accommodation,
She didn't like the film and it's just...
It's the other things that come along
yeah,
with the film.
I like the food. I don't like doing my intro and my outro.
Why not?
I sweat.
You're like,
I'm like, oh, I can't cope. Can't deal with it. Can't do it. No. I have to take a good deep breath in and I have to close my eyes and just do my first intro and then I'm done. I'm okay then.
Yeah, after your first one.
After my first one, I'm all right.
Yeah. It's the first one of each day.
Yes. I panic.
You have to just get yourself settled in.
Yeah.
So I'm going to dehydrate the nail with the nail prep dehydrator. You've got so tiny, tiny fingers. They're so tiny. Mind you, you'd look a bit weird with big, massive ones, wouldn't you? You'd look a bit strange. I'm going to use the acid-based primer. Now, this is my favourite. The scent is just delicious. Delightful. That was a joke.
I think it smells like cat wee.
Wow. Faye thinks it smells like bum.
Bum?
I don't know whose bum she's been smelling.
I'm not saying I smell cat wee, but...
Yeah. It is a bit cat wee, you know what you've said?
I just think it's cat wee.
It is a bit cat wee.
Yeah. Ammonia.
Yeah.
A bit cat wee.
Cat wee.
It's not cat wee. Please don't try and use cat wee. It won't have the same effect.
No animals were harmed.
So what we're going to do is, I've got lots of little dishes. So many dishes. I could use one more really, but I haven't got another one. So we'll just empty one of the other ones. I'm going to use Max Adehsion. Because I don't want to use Max Adehsion. Do you like this?
Yes.
You like it a lot?
Yeah.
She likes high speed.
I like fast.
I use a bit of both. 3D, I use high speed, rest max.
Yeah, brilliant, isn't it, for 3D? Absolutely amazing.
I can't be bothered waiting.
I know. Impatient.
Yes.
Yeah. Right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in each of these pots some Max Adhesion. Shots!
I think there might actually be another little...
Have you got another dish? Have you got another dish? Get me a dish! Maybe. Got one!
Got one!
Yes! We have another dish! 5 gel polishes. They are luminous.
It's
say it like that. Luminous Atomic Tangerine. We've got Icy Blizzard, which is a nice blue. Get the lid back on, girls. And we have what? Ectoplasm. And so nice. Glad Vicky's hair.
And my hair.
This one has no label, but we know what it's called, don't we? It's called
Hazardous.
There we are. That's hazardous. It's very hazardous. It's terrible.
So hazardous the label fell off.
Yeah. And then this one is 485. Have we got
it? Because that's an F number, I don't think I've got it.
485. Adam will link it below. It is, this is the old label, that's why, but it is a luminous one. We've checked. Adam's been in the kitchen, turn the lights off and had a little check.
That come in handy.
It does. So what we're going to do is we're going to drop some gel polish into the monomer. I'm going to mix it up. Oh, look at the butterfly, it's going to be now going to be coral. Between each colour, I'm going to need another dampen disc just to clean off any residue of the previous colour. So I don't want that to affect the next colour that I'm popping the brush into. I don't want it to contaminate it. Obviously, we're doing a kind of rainbow today. Oh, that one's... Yeah, I like that one like it is. We're doing a rainbow, but if you're doing just one colour, obviously it's less time consuming. I think we'll go in that order. Would you think in a different order?
No.
Or that order. So that's on the yeah. That on the thumb.
Yeah.
Yeah? Blue on the thumb?
Yeah.
Right then. I'm excited! I like doing new things. It's a bit of an experiment, this is. If I'm honest.
Vicky the guinea pig.
Oh, yeah.
Right, okay. Oh, God. I feel a bit nervous. There'll be lovely colours for like spring. So we're in spring now. When's it going to be summer anyway? I'm still waiting for a bit of summer. You see that? Nearly went in the wrong pot. Looks like an ice blizzard, just like it's called. So I started at the free edge because that will set up at a similar time to the product that's on Vicky's nail because of the heat from Vicky's living body.
I'm glad I'm not dead.
Yeah. Not yet.
No.
Not for a long, long, long time. Now, once you're happy with your colour, you can then your clear on top. So I'm going to go into monomer that has no colour added to it. And then I can make sure I've got my apex. So now we're going to go with the green. Oh, I like your hair. Each time I go in, I do make sure I sort of give it a bit of a whoosh round. Give it a little stir, make sure everything's still not set. Because what happens is, we've done this technique before, and if you leave it too long, it settles to the bottom, the gel does, and you don't want the gel to settle at the bottom. It's really difficult to see the colour when it's on top of the sculpting foam, but as soon as you put it onto the natural nail, that's when you can see that colour. I'm going to add a little bit of mylar, this one. And that'll just stick onto the acrylic because it's wet. And it's still thicker. A little bit thicker. I'm going to go over the top of that with a little bit of the green. And then the rest will be done with clear to encapsulate and add structure. So tipping the finger down and pulling the product down the nail. So we're going to pop a pinching tool on that, let that pinch. I'm going to pinch down the length with my fingers because the pinching tool will not go. It'll only touch this part. It will not touch this part. So you need to pinch the rest of it with your fingers to get a nice tight curve. And then we're going to do yellow. Yellow. And I've got some Mylar Flakes Lemon Sorbet. I want to put some in here as well.
No seagulls here.
Do you get seagull noises?
Oh my god, get them on the roof. Hit a pattern across the roof. Mm-hmm. They go, all the time.
We're by the sea in Hartlepool.
Yeah.
A little bit of yellow again. What kind of nails did you do in the salon then, Vic? What did you get a lot of?
I get loads of, like, just all sorts, really. I don't get, rare that I do gel polish.
Really?
Long, yeah.
So again, giving it a little bit of a mix around. So I'm mainly working on the free edge. And I'll work my way back to the cuticle. Pinch this one. Going to leave one plain and with no mylar and just so we've got a different look. And then we're going to do this one now, the baby one. He's a baby. Clean your brush.
My tiny fingers.
Yeah. See, this one's definitely started to settle at the bottom. I can just see little bits, so we're going to little mix around. We will put a little bit of mylar into this one. Because it's a little finger, we'll go a little bit shorter. So we've got this mylar, whatever that is, that number. A little bit of colour over the top just to intensify the colour. So I'm going to take the forms off the ones that are already done while I wait for that one to settle a little bit.
Is that just for comfort?
Yeah, because it's like taking off your bra, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's a nice feeling. See, these two will put some stones on.
Yes.
That's why we left them.
Yes.
With no stones.
Bling.
With no bling, no glitter, because they're going to just bling. Be clear. They're going to be the nice soft colour and then bling.
Okay.
Yeah. Bling, bling.
I've had like so many years of not being able to wear bling.
Oh, God, yeah, cool.
Couldn't, like, if I lost one, it wouldn't be good.
So I'm going to go through my normal filing routine with these nails now. Because it's a stiletto, I can pull from the sidewall straight to the tip to get that nice sharp point.
I haven't done a stiletto in I don't know how long. Nobody ever asks for them.
What do they have?
Like ballerina, coffin, whatever they want to call it.
Mm-hmm.
Did some square the other day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I did some square the other day. Square, French.
I did.
And I was like, I actually quite liked them. I think because I hadn't done them for ages, it was quite refreshing to do something.
I did
want to
just taper them in a little bit though.
I did. They were slightly tapered.
Yeah, I wanted to, but no, I didn't. I really wanted to.
You find things come and go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what's fashionable at the moment?
Rainbow, fades, ombres. The amount of, ombre shades that I've done.
Everybody wants a ballerina, don't they?
Yeah.
Or a coffin.
Coffin.
So I'm making sure I contour the nail. I have used a soft file around the cuticle area because Vicky has very delicate skin. I'm going to do this on all of the nails now, get them all shaped up. Turn your hands over for me. To get even more clarity, I'm going to top coat the underside of the nails. You don't want to touch the skin, but you want to make sure you go right to the edges. Just going to pull my fingers.
That's a big hole.
Pop that into the lamp upside down for me. Awesome. Right, so turn them over. What I'm going to do is, because I'm going to bling out this one and I'm going to bling out this one, I'm just going to top coat the three nails with the mylar in while I select some bling bling. They do kind of look like sweeties. I get why they call them jelly. So I've just taken some stones out of the packets and put them into some little pots. I'm sure Adam will list them below. I've got some gel residue wipe-off solution in a little dampen dish. We're going to use the most amazing adhesive ever for stones, the acrygel. We're going to use it in its clear here. Pop it on, and then you want to dip your gel brush into gel residue wipe-off solution so you can move the acrygel around and place it where you want it. So wherever you're going to put those stones is where you want to put it. I'm going to build up a peaked. But like, see how this one's quite high? That's what I want to do, so building. And then we're going to blend it so it's seamless. kind of like them knitters that you get that say no VPL. They lie though, don't they? They can always see, I think. Buy them knitters that says no VPL, no visible panty line.
Just don't wear any.
Well, I've got a friend that does that and I'm too scared to do that. Because I think if a gust of wind just catches out of my skirt and then whoop! I'm going to top coat over the top of the acrygel. We have not cured it, don't worry. We have not missed a step. This has not been cured. Press the stone into the acrygel.
Wow. Oh, I'm so happy.
You're so happy?
Yeah. The bling.
The bling, the bling.
Everywhere.
All the bling. You want all the bling.
Ain't no thing.
If it ain't got that bling.
Bling, 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 bling. Oh my God. It's a good job that's not my middle finger. I'd just be showing it everybody.
That one is in my neck.
Yeah. Well, you've seen it. Have you seen it? This one will still be on in about 2 months' time.
Just keep infilling
it. I just
it.
Keep putting some more around the base. Yes. I just thought, oh, it's just going to be a little bit of a hobby. I'll do my nails. I'll do my mate's nails.
Yeah.
You've got a cool story, though, about, like, why you...
Because I had no girlfriends. Because I work in a factory full of men.
Mm-hmm.
And, I thought, how can I get some girlfriends? I thought, I'll do some nails. They'll have to like me. Yeah. Basically bought my friends. Some of my best mates I've met through doing nails. I'm trying to think. Actually, all of my friends I have met doing nails.
Is there not any girls working at that, what's it, that place?
There's a couple. There's like maybe 5 or 6 out of like 3,000 that work on the shop floor. So, minority.
My mate works at JCB. And she's like one of the only girls that works there.
Kirsty is with the in the chemical. She's a minority.
I suppose engineering and chemicals and stuff, it's always been seen as a man's job, it is, you know.
Girls don't want to do it though.
Yeah.
That's the thing that they're trying to change.
Yeah, they're trying to change the idea of what the job is.
Yeah. I used to go into schools and promote engineering and... You know, girls coming into the factory and stuff. Girls just don't want to do it.
Mm. Why do you think that is?
Don't know. No idea.
Right, we're going to bling up this one as well. Let's go to this side. I'm going to move it over this side because I've just been thinking. When you're doing nails...
That it file it.
Yeah, you'll have filing it. I'll move it over to this side and you won't file it.
The other girls in the salon, we've all got the same like marks on our fingers, you know, where you catch the file. I had like 6 or 7 sets in the other day, so I had to take my fingers off.
Oh, that's it's horrible, isn't it, that when you've got them back to back, absolutely loads, and you just end up obliterating your fingers.
Yeah.
I mean, I changed my file in the positioning with my fingers to to stop that happening, because it was just getting beyond a joke when I was doing that many. So painful.
Because I've never done it. I've only ever done like a couple of sets, like a week.
I'm in love. Let's finish off with a little bit of cuticle oil. Bling, bling.
I think it's the most bling I've ever had.
Is it?
Yeah.
Which one's your favourite?
That one.
That one, though. It was the green.
It was the green.
And now it's this one.
Now it's
one.
That one, yes.
Yeah.
It's the crystal nail.
Yeah. I have that on a month. Imagine how heavy they'd be then.
I know. I love them. I love them. Beautiful.
Everyone's going to be so jealous.
They are. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything I've used today, even the stones and everything, will be listed below. And we'll also link the Pretty Little Claws channel as well, so you can watch Vicky doing her thing. Say bye-bye.
Bye!
Bye-bye!
Oh,
I need
to
You can't see the other ones, it's got too much bling on.
It's got so much bling on.
Did
you glow? Yeah.
Let me see.
Oh, wow.
Are we ready? Are we cooking on gas? Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. Welcome to, well, just shut up because I've already said that bit. That is broken. That is not one.
It's a jelly stamper.
That's a jelly stamper.
That one's broken.
That is broken.
I know, you're just acrylic
it. I know, I thought, well, if I put acrylic liquid in it, it's still going to work. I need to like, use some it. That won't corrode away.
We fixed this camera the other day.
Oh, we do that all the time. We're always fixing camera equipment.
I was like, oh, you fixed that? I went, yeah, I acrylic it.
Yeah. I've done that.